नित्यानंदेश्वर परम शिव समारंभाम् नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वंदे गुरु परंपराम्। I welcome you all with my love and respect. I welcome all the visitors, viewers, Sarvanyapita Yajamans, Kartas, Srimahans, Mahans, Tanidar, Kotari, Kayakalpa Yoga participants, E-Gurukul students, Kailasas, NHU students, thousands of Paramashivoham level 2 participants were sitting with me in thousands of Nityananda Sabhas all over the world. I welcome all of you. And all the living and practicing Hindus from all over the world, I welcome all of you. All those who are joining with us live on Kailasa TV, Kailasas NTV, Kailasas Hinduism Now TV, Kailasas Enlighten App, Kailasas Nayana Diksha, and other social media platforms such as YouTube Live, Facebook Live, and Twitter. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. Paramashiva's message directly to the world, the views, Kailasa's views and suggestions for the post-COVID-19 world. Hindu solutions. First thing, all Hindus should understand, even though we are not reason for the problems, we Hindus should take the responsibility to find solutions, because from the time immemorial, Hinduism is a religion, tradition. Continuously, immensely contributes to the world by finding solutions for every crisis humanity faces. Every crisis humanity faces. Hinduism found solutions. Hinduism is the religion which has seen at least 5 complete wiping out of planet Earth, wiping out of civilization. And we have knowledge, we have recorded and documented every time when the civilization was wiped out, how we rebuilt it. Please understand, we Hindus have knowledge. All the 18 Puranas and Upapuranas are history, cosmic history, not mythology. At least 5 times the whole civilization was wiped out on planet Earth, and we handled it. We handled the crisis. When there is a global emergencies, the knowledge of the past is too important. How human beings handled it, what all the methods successfully helped human beings to recover from the global crisis. Understand? First thing, Hindus need to realize you have solution. Please look back your history. Stop abusing them as mythology, because anti-Hindus have abused it. That's the first thing I wanted to share. Whether from binary logic or cosmic logic, Hindus have solution. And even as per the modern history, even as per the date, time, binary logic recordings, historical archives, it is well established fact, Hinduism is the oldest knowledge tradition. Oldest knowledge tradition still alive, the oldest living civilization which has faced large number of this kind of crisis in multiple levels, whether health related pandemics or natural calamities, all the global crises, human beings faced. We have the clear knowledge, we have clear manual, how we handled it. Manu, collecting all the species and keeping in a boat, a large ship, I should say, large ship. And after the world's greatest deluge, parking the ship in the land, available land, and restarting the civilization is a history, not mythology. The large shark which pulled the ship, that shark remains as the flag symbol of Pandya kingdom. Manu's ship, large ship, landed near Kanyakumari. Manu had one son, one daughter. The daughter was given the area called Kumari Kandam. That is called Kanyakumari, and the land connected to Bharatavarsha. The son's name is Eelam. He was given Sri Lanka. That is why Sri Lanka has the name Eelam. Understand, all these are historical facts, not mythology or stories. Anyhow, all I am trying to convey is, first of all, Hindus need to know we have solution because we faced multiple pandemics, natural calamities, and we have expertise. We just need to revisit our Puranas with the clarity they are history documents, not mythology. They are history documents. So now, yesterday I was explaining few points. We need to contemplate on cosmic logic. Why we are going through what we are going through. As I said, cosmic logic only we call as karma. Cosmic solutions we call as dharma. What is the karma caused COVID-19, coronavirus? I can say multiple reasons. Let's intranalyze one by one. The karma caused this problem and the dharma solution for this problem. Understand? I'll make a clear revelations, Hindu solutions, karma caused the problems of COVID-19 and all the other related problems of COVID-19 and dharma, cosmic solutions for these problems. Hinduism teaches constantly only if you look at the root of the problem, source of the problem, without getting overwhelmed and trying to find stopgap or superficial solution. Understand? Even if the problem is overwhelming, do not go for stopgap or superficial solution. Go into the root of the problem, look into the root of the problem, find the right, permanent, ultimate, complete solution. And, ultimate, permanent, complete solution is always time-taking process. Is delusion. People want to force stop gap of baked vested interests, superficial solutions on you, are making you believe you need to accept the stopgap superficial solution for immediate purpose. Understand? surely we need to protect ourselves immediately. That is true. Protecting ourselves, quarantine, all that should be followed. But you need to know, all that is not permanent solution. Please understand, precautionary methods cannot be promoted as solution. Understand the difference between these two. Quarantine is a great precautionary method to prevent, that need to be followed. I strongly recommend all of you follow the local government's guidance, guidelines, regulations. In each country, based on the situation, the local governments would have given suggestions, guidelines, orders. Please follow all of it very strictly, sincerely. But you need to understand, these are prevention, not solution. If we don't look at the permanent solution, we will be having one or other this kind of pandemics and crisis continuously. We need to understand, we really, really need to look in, intra-analyze. Too many deluded decisions we have taken, deluded conclusions we have arrived, deluded cognitions we are carrying. Yesterday I was talking about plant-based diet, vegetarian lifestyle, not just diet, whole lifestyle, plant-based lifestyle, stopping the idea that whole planet Earth belongs to only human race. Human race may be superior race because of its ability to torture and kill and eliminate other beings. But we need to know, planet Earth is not exclusively for us. We are here to coexist. Since the civilization, human civilization started, we lost 83% of wild mammals. Understand, whatever I am talking is from clear binary logic information. I am not even talking from cosmic logic. I am talking from binary logic. Even in binary logic level, 83% of the wild mammals we lost. 80% of marine mammals we lost. 50% of plants we lost, 15% of fish we lost. I'll tell you, animal-based lifestyle, just for our small luxuries, comforts, taste bud satisfaction. We are ready to torture and kill animal. Fur belongs to them, not this body. You can't remove fur from their body and use it on your body. You can't torture and kill and eliminate. Neither cosmic logic nor binary logic. Allows us to conclude the animal-based lifestyle is right. Please be very clear. Cosmic logic and binary logic, both are very clear. Meat-based diet or animal-based lifestyle means using animal products for your comfort, luxury in any form is not right, not sustainable, not the right way to exist for a long time. We are deluded with our extreme greed and selfishness. We are forgetting the environmental impact of livestock. The environmental impact of livestock, whether the water, fresh water needed, or the planet's land surface occupied by the livestock industry, the national water footprint in the US alone, and human induced greenhouse gas emissions due to livestock, pastures and range lands have been degraded due to overgrazing and erosion in every level. The meat-based lifestyle and animal products being used for cosmetics or as clothes in any other way for our lifestyle is not going to be sustainable and it is not right. As per binary logic and as per cosmic logic, both level. I request Hindus to start setting a trend all over the world. There are 2 billion living, practicing, born Hindus all over the world. I request all of you, living, practicing, born Hindus, first let us set a trend of moving to nature-based lifestyle. Let's stop torturing, killing animals. Let's drop this idea planet Earth is exclusively for us. Let's drop this demonic cognition, demonic tendency of concluding the whole planet Earth is our exclusive right. No. Let us learn aparigraha and asteya, non-stealing and living with minimal things. Let's end consumeristic culture. Let's end consumerism as religion. I tell you, modern day media cult is promoting consumeristic cult as the success of the life. Success of the life is not becoming slave of consumeristic cult, which is promoted by modern mass media cult. Mass media is cult. Consumerism is a cult. Becoming slave for consumeristic cult because of the mass media cult is brainwashing you is the worst delusion with which humanity is suffering. That is the source of multiple pandemics and crises yet to come. Understand? Separate the technological modern day achievements of science and human civilization and the consumeristic cult. Unfortunately, mass media is brainwashing you by putting this consumeristic cult ideas and the great achievements of science, technology of the humanity together as one concept called progressive lifestyle. No. Wake up to this truth. Hinduism had ultimate knowledge about the cosmos, everything. The scientific discoveries, evolution, thought current, whether the field of physics, chemistry, biology, cosmology, medicine, psychology, consciousness, every field, Hinduism had absolute, extreme, unimaginable knowledge minus consumeristic cult. In the modern day, human beings are brainwashed by mass media cult, the consumeristic cult, and the modern day human civilization's achievement, both are put together. And you are made to believe both together is our lifestyle. No. Learn to differentiate between these two. Don't get enamored, deluded. Consumeristic cult is not sustainable model. Aparigraha, learning to live with minimal things. Asteya, non-stealing. Stop stealing skin from animals for your luxury and arrogance and ego. Stop stealing from other beings what is given for their life stop stealing them for your luxury human beings need to learn asteya non stealing you have no right to steal whether skin or life from animals for your taste bud or luxury or comfort We need to learn asteya and aparigraha. Do you know the fresh water needed for meat versus plant-based diet? To produce 1 kg tomato, the fresh water needed and to produce 1 kg beef the fresh water needed I am showing you the reports ₹15,000 water is required to produce 1 kg of beef fresh water and to produce 1 kg of tomato only minuscule part of the 15,000 liter water is needed and the amount of energy beef gives and the amount of energy tomato gives if you compare we are entering into a disastrous suicidal lifestyle by adopting meat based lifestyle not only non sustainable but suicidal humanity need to wake up we are not only entering into a non sustainable we are entering into suicidal lifestyle by behaving arrogantly thinking just because we can kill we have a capacity to kill we have a right to kill no you having capacity to kill is given only for survival need to defend yourself in the life or death situation but the capacity to kill cannot be misused for your food and other luxurious needs and taste buds stop using capacity to kill as regular lifestyle just for your food and other luxurious items and needs humanity wake up your ability to kill is not given to you to be professionally skillfully exercised on large scale on this planet earth with the idea of earth exclusively belongs to us no non violence should become lifestyle your ability to kill can be exercised only if your life is in direct immediate imminent threat and danger like some animal is trying to kill you literally in next few minutes you have right to defend yourself and kill other than those kind of situations nowhere that capacity to kill can be used every human being who eats meat or animal based products in your life should understand You may not kill directly, but you pay someone to kill for you. Paying someone to kill for you is as good as you killing. I think if you kill, at least one day you will realize, seeing the pain of the animal, and you will stop eating meat because somebody else is killing and it is neatly packed and brought to the shelves of the stores, food stores. You are not even remembering. You are paying to kill every day. Millions or maybe even billions of animals. Let's stop releasing not only carbon dioxide, karma also, pain and suffering also. When you kill animals, when you keep the livestock and kill animals, not only you disturb the environment as per binary logic, you disturb the ecosystem by releasing so much pain and suffering. As per cosmic logic and binary logic, in both levels, you are polluting the world through meat-based lifestyle, animal product-based lifestyle. I want the humanity to contemplate on this enough of delusion. Let's get back to the right lifestyle. Even if it takes little time, let's go for permanent solution. Let's save planet Earth for future generations before it becomes too late. We have not yet reached the tipping point. Let us wake up now and protect planet Earth for our future. Do not live in the delusion that planet Earth is exclusively for us. No. Planet Earth is given to us, but not exclusively. I want all the Kailasavasis and Kailasaviswasis, Kailasavasis, people who are living in Kailasa all over the world, and Kailasaviswasis, sympathizers of Kailasa and Hindus, I sincerely request and recommend, let us start building self-sustaining communities all over the world as model community trend setting, self-sustaining agriculture-based communities. O Hindus, even if we set the trend of just 10,000 communities all over the world, self-sustaining, nature-friendly, organic, vegetarian life base, we will set a model for the whole world to learn. This is the first priority. O Hindus, if you are really listening to me, if you are really interested in saving the world, if you are really, really interested in permanent solution, not just small, small prevention methods or superficial solution, if you are looking for permanent solution, create Kailasa communities all over the world. Move to the communities. Let's set model communities. Let's put our time, treasure, talent and make agriculture-based, self-sustaining, goshala-based, agriculture-based, vegetarian, non-violent lifestyle communities which live successfully as per the cosmic logic. Success defined by consumeristic cult and spread by the mass media cult is the worst delusion with which humanity is suffering. Let me repeat. Successful life defined by mass media cult supported by consumeristic cult. Consumeristic cult promotes mass media cult. Mass media cult promotes consumeristic cult. Who is spending for advertisements and sustaining the mass media cult? Consumeristic cult. Who is constantly brainwashing you? Consumeristic cult is the right lifestyle. Mass media cult. It's a modern day demon. Stop getting brainwashed and save yourself from consumeristic cult and mass media cult. And start living with asteya, aparigraha, non-stealing. And living with minimal things. Stop stealing from animals their organs or their life itself. Stop stealing from animals their organs or life itself. Understand get back to non-violent lifestyle. This is the dharma we need to follow to get out of the karma we created due to our delusion and wrong conclusion. I will continue to give the views and solutions of Kailasa Hindu solution for the post-corona world. We need to wake up. We really, really need to set model communities all over the world. Everywhere we need to set this vegetarian lifestyle as a trend. We need to set at least in few places Fortunately, already many Kailasavasis have given their time, life itself, and many Viswasis, sympathizers, devotees, supporters have given talent and treasure. We just need to organize ourselves and set the model communities, sustainable, vegetarian, organic, cosmic logic tuned. Kailasas need to be established as a model to the whole world. Understand? The mass media cult is promoting consumeristic cult wildly and violently. Whole humanity is getting brainwashed. Unless now we Hindus wake up and set this model communities to showcase to the world and educate the world. World will gain confidence about good things only if you demonstrate. About bad things, if you just instigate their taste and luxury and pleasure instincts, they will be addicted. But for good things, you need to prove by establishing, setting a trend. So understand, it is we Hindus, our responsibility to establish this sustainable, cosmic logic based communities all over the world, at least for people to learn, see and pick up and learn and practice. Karma is the reason for corona. One of the reason for corona is consumeristic cult promoted by mass media cult. Dharma, cosmic solution for this karma is set up Kailasas all over the world and demonstrate it to the world. Non-violence, ahimsa based, asteya, non-stealing based, aparigraha, living with minimal things based, successful, natural, organic, eco-friendly, cosmic logic adopted communities, which I call in one single word Kailasa, all over the world. We just need to set Kailasas all over the world and set a trend and show to the world. Understand, it is not luxury anymore, it is survival need. If any of you understand what I am talking, please take action immediately, as early as possible. move to nearest Kailasa or create the Kailasa where you are. Let's make model communities before it is too late. Your ambitions, ideas about successful life, which is promoted by consumeristic cult and modern media cult, the brainwashing done to you by the so-called idea of successful life by modern day modern media cult, mass media cult and consumeristic cult is too much before it becomes too late. Get out of this brainwashing by consumeristic cult and modern, the mass media cult. Let's create the model Kailasas all over the world. And I wanted to thank sincerely the devotees who contributed the large piece of land in Australia. To the devotees who contributed the large piece of land in Australia to make the Kailasa ecosystem. Let us all focus and sincerely put our efforts to get out of this brainwash done to us by mass media cult and consumeristic cult and create sustainable, nature-friendly, eco-friendly, cosmic logic-centered, non-violence-based, non-stealing-based, living with minimal things-based, Kailasa ecosystems all over the world. This is the permanent dharmic solution. I request all of you to start discussions in this line all over the world and set model communities all over the world for the humanity to learn and practice, imbibe. With this, I bless you all. Let's all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Shuddhadvaita Saivam, living and radiating the state, space, powers, being, super consciousness and Kailasa of Paramashiva. Paramashivoham Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. The eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.